Good morning, students of class 9. Now, welcome back to the e-classes now. We are doing economics. The story of village Palampur. We are doing the first chapter. And we have reached the sixth point, the factor of production we are doing. Capital needed for farming. Capital means inputs. You require money. In order to do farming, you require money to purchase seeds, to purchase fertilizers, to pay the laborers, or to purchase insecticide, pesticide, or even for irrigation purposes. You require capital. So now capital needed in farming. That's the sixth point. Number A, there are altogether 7 points over here. So number A, as we have seen in our previous classes, we have seen that the modern farming methods at present to grow more food from the same piece of land, we need lot of inputs. Modern farming methods require a great deal of capital. You need a lot of money because there is a great demand of food crops or food grains in the market. As the population is rising or increasing, there is a great demand for food. So naturally, the farmers are pressurized to grow more and more food, and for that they require more capital. So for modern farming methods require a great deal of capital. So you can see number B, therefore so the farmers need more money than before. So they require more and more money than before. Moreover, most of the things, the prices of things are increasing day by day, year by year. The cost of farming is increasing. The cost of production is rising. As the capital is one of the most important factor of production. Without capital, it's quite difficult to do or produce. You need capital in order to produce goods or products. So number C, most of the small farmers who owned a small plot of land, most of the small farmers had to borrow money to arrange for the capital during the farming season, especially during the sowing period. Small farmers, they have to arrange capital as they do not have any kind of savings, because their small plot of land does not give them enough income that is only sufficient for the family consumption, personal consumption only. They could not sell their product in the market so that they could save. So every time they have to arrange for the capital during the farming period. They borrow. So what they do then, the small farmers, they borrow from large farmers, or sometimes from village money lenders, or sometimes from traders. They borrow from large farmers or village money lenders, or sometimes traders. They have to borrow money or capital. These lenders means provider of the money, such as money lender, big farmers, traders. These lenders supply various inputs. Input means things required during production. So various inputs such as capital, money. They provide money. Sometimes they provide tools, implements, farming implements, fertilizers, insecticide, etc. for cultivation to the small farmers in cash and kind. So they provide as a loan. Therefore, the rate of interest on such informal loans is very, very high, many, many times higher than the formal sector, such as banks. So in the banks, the bank will charge interest per year, but these money lenders, traders, and village big farmer, they will charge interest per month. So that will be too much and too high. So the rate of interest on such for informal loans is very high. So they are put to great distress, difficulties. They find it very, very difficult to repay the loan. They are put to great distress to repay the loan. They find it very difficult. Sometimes they find it quite impossible to pay the loan. So therefore, many small farmers fall into debt traps. They fall into debt traps. They could not come out. And if they have to come out from the debt traps, they have to sell their property. Or sometimes they have to sell a piece of land or the property in order to come out from the debt trap. So you can see number G. So far we have talked about small farmers. Most of the small farmers have to arrange capital during farming period or season. But what they do, they borrow money from money lenders or traders and village landlords. So their rate of interest is very, very high, and sometimes they fall into debt traps and it is quite impossible to repay the loan, and they have to sell their property. Now we'll look at the medium and large farmers. In contrast means comparison. In comparison to the small farmers, when you compare small farmers and big farmers or medium farmers, in comparison to small farmers or contrast, large and medium farmers have their own savings from farming by selling in surplus farm products. Previous year, they sell surplus farm products and they save money in the bank. And for the next farming season, they will use that surplus amount as capital in the farm. So they do not have any problem regarding or arranging the capital for farming. So that means they are able to arrange for the capital needed for farming during that particular year. The problem lies with the small farmers. So you know that. How these small farmers arrange capital for their farming. So most of the small farmers, they find it very, very difficult. They find it difficult to repay the loan and they fall into debt traps. So whereas the large and medium farmers, they do not have such problems. They have surplus amount in the bank and they use that amount as capital for farming. So in the next video, that is number 7, sale of surplus. Surplus means extra. Sale of surplus farm products. Farm products means food grains, raw materials, whatever raw materials they produce, such as cotton, sugarcane, rubber, tea, jute, indigo. These are farm products, or sometimes food grains, fruits, vegetables. These are all farm products. So the sale of surplus farm products, in our next class we'll do that. Till then you go through this, go through the book as well. So we are coming to the end. It's not far away now. We are coming, proceeding towards the end of this chapter. So sale of surplus farm products. Till then you read. Don't waste your time and keep on watching the video and going through the book as well. So later on I'll provide whatever question answer, whatever thing is there, I'll provide so that you can practice at home for self-assessment. So that's all for today. We'll meet in the next video. Thank you very much for today.